listen to the school congruency. School what? Congruency. What is the meaning of congruency? If we look to our hands, we notice that they are the same. They have the same size and they have the same length of finger. So, these two hands is called what? Is called congruency. It's called what? Congruency. And we denoted this by this straight line, like equal, and we add another line. This is called congruency. And this is read as congruent two. Okay? Now, if we have two shaped like this, this is the first one, and this is the second one. This two shape is called polygon. It's called what? Polygon. We take this in the other, with the last type. What is the meaning of polygon? Polygon is a shape consists of three sides or more. Okay? And it must be closed and without any curve. Like what? Like, for example, a triangle. If we have any triangle, this is consists of three lines. And this closed shape and without any curved line. So this triangle is called what? It's called polygon. It's called polygon. So we have the first polygon here and the second polygon here. What we notice about this polygon? Yes, they are the same. They are the same. Look with me. How they are the same? If we look about A, B, we find this is equal to the corresponding side in the other shape is called EF. So we can say AB is a side. AB equal to the corresponding side EF. And we have another line. AD is equal to the corresponding side in the other polygon is called EH. So we can say AD is equal to EH. And if we have another line like DC, DC is equal to the corresponding side HG. So we can see DC equal to the side HG. And we have the last line BC is equal to the corresponding side FG. So, BC is equal to what? BC is equal to FG. So, we have each line or each side in the first figure is equal to each side in the second figure. And we have what also? We have our angle R equal. What this means? This means the first angle A is equal to the corresponding angle E in the other shape. And we have angle B is equal to angle F. And we have angle G is equal to angle C. And the last one, angle D is equal to angle H. So we have each side in the first figure is equal to each. start here from E H. We write E H G F. Okay? So our order is very important. So we have a special case. The first one here is called the square. How we can say two squares are congruent? He said what? He said the side length of one of them is equal to the side length of the other. What does this mean? If we have two squares like this, and these two squares, I need to know they are congruent. So I must have only one side here is equal to one side in the other side. Why we say this? Because, for example, all of you know that the square, all sides are equal. So if I find this line equal, for example, 5 centimeters, so this line equal 5 centimeters because we say they are equal. So we say, but all sides are equal, so this line equal 5, so all of these equal what? Equal 5. And all sides here equal what? Equal also 5. And all of you know that the angle of the square is right. So we have all angle is right, so they are equal. So these two squares are congruent. So if he say only one side in the square are equal to one side in the other square, only one of them, so we can say they are congruent. And the second one is called what? The rectangle. The rectangle are congruent if the two dimensions of one of them are equal to the two dimensions of the other. What does this mean? What is the meaning of dimension? Dimension, it means length and width. So if I draw two rectangles like this, this is the first one, and this is the second one. How can I say they are congruent? If we find only side here, only length in the first one equal the length in the second one, and we find the width in the first one equal the width in the second one. Why? If we write here this line equal 5 centimeters, so this line also equal what? 5 centimeters. And all of you know that the each two opposite sides are equal in length in the rectangle. So if we find this line equal 5, so we write here also 5 and here equal 5. If we find this width equal 3, so we can write this is equal 3 and this is equal 3 because each two opposite sides are equal in length. So we find our lengths are equal, and all of you know that the rectangle have a right angle in each angle. So the angles are equal. So we have our side are equal and our angles are equal. So we can say these two rectangles are congruent. So if I need to know how we can find two rectangles are congruent, if we find what the length and width in the first one are equal, or the two dimensions of one of them are equal to the two dimensions of the other. And the third one is called triangle. How we can say the two triangles are congruent if the corresponding sides of two triangles are equal? What does this mean? And if we find the first line here equal to the first line, and the second line equal to the second line, and the third line equal to the third line, so we can say they are what? They are congruent. Okay? Let me solve this complete. Two squares are congruent if the side length of one of them equal to what? Equal to, yes, the side length of the other. And the two rectangles are congruent if the two dimensions of one of them are what? Are Yes, equal measure of angle C. So I must write what? Listen here. Measure, open our bracket, write angle C. And close our bracket. Okay? Okay. In the second one, measure of angle N. Measure of angle N. N is equal to what is the other side? Yes, measure of angle what? Z. So we write measure of angle Z. Okay, measure of angle O. This angle is equal to measure of angle what? Y. So we write measure, open our bracket, angle Y. And measure of angle P is equal to its other side, measure of angle what? Measure of angle X. Okay? Let me see here, in the opposite figure, in triangle ADC is congruent to triangle LMN, complete. Here he said what? Triangle ADC is congruent to LMN. We can find each side and each angle from this letter. How we can find this? Listen here. Here I need to find measure of angle M equal what? Let me see, measure of angle M. I have measure of angle M. No, but we have what? We have the congruent angle or the equal angle. We can find this from our letter. Listen here. Here we have what? Measure of angle M is equal what in the other shape? Yes. Measure of angle what? P. And P here equal what? Equal 50 degrees. So we can write here 50 degrees. So measure of angle M, we must write here equal 50 degrees. Measure of angle N. Where is angle N? Here, we have measure of angle N? No, so we must look about what? About the equal angle. Where is the equal angle in N? N here is equal to measure of angle what? C. We have measure of angle C? Yes, this is equal what? 70. So we write 70. Measure of angle L equal 70 degrees. I need to find measure of angle L. Where is measure of angle L? We have measure of angle L? No, but we have our corresponding angle. L equal what? Equal A. We have A? No. But we can find this from the sum of interior angle of the triangle. We know that the sum of any angles or all angles in the triangle equal what? Equal 180 degrees. So we can write root the sum of interior angle of triangle equal what? Equal 180 degrees. So I have the three angles equal 180 degrees. And we have two angles of them. So how we can find the third one? We write what? We write 180 minus. Open our bracket. We write the sum of these two angles. 70 plus what? 70 plus 50. All of this equal what? Here 70 plus 50 equal 120. And 180 minus 120 equal what? Equal 60 degrees. So we find measure of angle L equal 60 degrees. The second part here is called what? Symmetrical figures and line of symmetry. What is the meaning of lines of symmetry? It's a line segment divided any shape into two congruent parts. It's like a mirror. For example, here I have a polygon A, B, C, D. And where is our mirror here? Is XY, this line. So this mirror make what? Is divided this polygon into two congruent parts. And we can write what? We can write the figure A, X, Y, D. So we have how many mirror mechanics? This is the first mirror. It divided this into two equal parts. This is the first one, and this is the second one. And we have also another line. The second line here. This is the second line of symmetry, and the third by the same way. Okay, so we have how many lines of symmetry? We have three. So in the parallelogram and trapezium and the screen triangle, we didn't have any line of symmetry. We didn't have what? Any line of symmetry. We can ask about the line of symmetry of parallelogram equal, we write here. We didn't have any line of symmetry, okay? And which have one line of symmetry? Isosceles triangle and isosceles trapezium. Number one, like I. So we start from isosceles triangle and isosceles trapezium. Okay? And two have what? The rectangle and rhombus has two line of symmetry. So we can say rectangle, rhombus, two. Rectangle, rhombus, two. And has three line of symmetry, equilateral triangle. And all of you know the equilateral triangle has three sides are equal. So it has what? Three line of symmetry. And square has four line of symmetry. Square has what? How many sides? Four sides, and these four sides are equal. So we can write they have four line of symmetry. And the regular hexagon has how many line of symmetry? Has six line of symmetry. Like what? Like this shape. I have how many sides here? Hexagon has six sides. One, two, three, four, five, six. So it has what? How many line of symmetry? Six line of symmetry. Okay? And the infinite number is what? Is circle. Why? Because if we draw any circle, I can draw any mirror. I can draw any line of symmetry like this. Okay? So it has what? How many line of symmetry? It's an infinite number. Let me solve here. The rectangle has how many line of symmetry? We said what? A rectangle, rhombus, two. Rectangle, rhombus, two. So we can write two. The square has how many sides? Four. So the square has how many lines of symmetry? Four also. The rhombus has, we said what? A rectangle, rhombus, two. So we write two. The circle has how many lines of symmetry? We said what? Infinite number. We can draw any number of line of symmetry. So we can write infinite number. Okay, so a isosceles triangle has how many lines of symmetry? We say it's started from I, so it has one line of symmetry. Any isosceles has one line of symmetry. Okay? Okay. So the diagonal is a rectangle. Divided it into two. How we take this? Into two what? Into one triangle. But it's not like